Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Drew Abenhaus. Welcome to SICW Wrestling Explosion. We've got another action-packed episode for you today. We're fresh off of our huge show this past July. We want to thank all of the great fans for coming out. It was hot in the East Carondelet Community Center, and the action was hot as well. You've heard us talk for the last few weeks about the legends versus the monsters. That's what we're going to take a look at today, as the legendary team of Hall of Famer Cowboy Bob Orton, the Night Train Gary Jackson, and our classic wrestling champion Ron Powers lock horns with the monstrous team of Attila Khan, Kahagas, and a surprise partner for the monster team. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to see all of the fantastic action as soon as we hear a quick word from our sponsors.
The old season is over. The new season is coming. The Gateway Grizzlies are building for a spectacular campaign. The talent will be strong, hard-hitting, solid defense, reliable pitching. Plus, as always, the Grizzlies will have a schedule of superb promotions. It will be fun for the entire family at the right price. The Grizzlies were named the Frontier League Organization of the Year. The home for all this baseball excitement is a remarkable GCS ballpark. Make plans now to enjoy baseball the way it should be. For more information and updates, go to gatewaygrizzlies.com.
Unique and affordable gifts and collectibles on the internet are available at the Black Bear Haversack Trading Post. Go to blackbearhaversack.com. Semi-precious stones, bone horn and soapstone items, abalone shells, genuine coyote and water buffalo teeth pendants, products for Civil War, medieval and Renaissance reenactments, and so much more. For a 10% discount, mention SICW number 7 when you place your order. It's blackbearhaversack.com for top quality at reduced prices.
If you and your friends are looking for a great time, visit Stoney's Sports Pub at 3001 West Main in Belleville, Illinois. Gather your friends for some of the coldest beers and specials and join some of the best sports talk around. Don't forget to say hello to Shane Freeman and his very friendly staff. If you're looking for a great place to kick back and relax, it's Stoney's Sports Pub at 3001 West Main in Belleville, Illinois. Again, that address is Stoney's Sports Pub at 3001 West Main in Belleville, Illinois. We'll see you there.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. It's the calm before the storm here. The Night Train Gary Jackson teaming up with the Cowboy Bob Orton and Ron Powers, our classic wrestling champion, taking on Tokyo Monster Kahagas, Attila Khan, both of these men, or monsters rather, led by Travis Cook, and the man in the green trunks and black sleeveless tee currently entering the ring is a newcomer by the name of Vic the Bruiser. A newcomer to SICW, that is, not to the wrestling business. And of course, as you see in the lower right hand of your screen, manager Big Daddy, he was the man who introduced Vic the Bruiser to the East Carondelet Community Center. Big Daddy appeared earlier in the evening letting folks know that his 450-pound troll was no longer with him, and Big Daddy had searched the world over for a replacement that is just as monstrous, just as vicious as these other men. Vic the Bruiser is the man he found. And of course, Vic the Bruiser has been in the wrestling business since 1993, so he's a 23-year veteran, although he has yet to make his way to the Midwest, at least before this matchup. Here we go. We've seen this team of monsters successful so far in keeping the momentum in their favor. They had Gary Jackson isolated in their side of the ring for the beginning portions of this matchup. So early success for this team of monsters. And it's interesting to see how these three men can coexist. Kahagas, of course, from Tokyo, the Tokyo Monster. Attila Khan, the Mongolian Monster. And Vic the Bruiser, of course, from Chicago. So none of these three men even speak the same language. We'll see if the language of violence is enough to keep them on the same page against a team in Powers, Orton, and Jackson that you have to imagine are going to be a pretty well-oiled machine, as they have a united cause that they are battling against here today. And there you see Gary Jackson unleashing some of those golden gloves there, just lighting up Attila Khan with those lefts and rights. And that was enough to create the separation and get back to his corner to tag legendary Hall of Famer Cowboy Bob Orton. And folks, I say this is a main event in any building in the country, because you're going to be hard-pressed to find a match containing more in-ring experience than these six gentlemen. Just the team of Cowboy Bob Orton, Gary Jackson, and Ron Powers have a combined 96 years in the professional wrestling business. Of course, Cowboy Bob Orton making his debut in the 70s. Gary Jackson and Ron Powers both getting into the wrestling in the late 80s and early 90s. So again, 96 years of experience between those three men. Vic the Bruiser has 23 years of experience. Cahagas has been in the wrestling business since 2000. And Attila Khan is the newcomer here to us. But Attila, who knows, might be some sort of brass knuckles champion from Mongolia. And folks, there was, amidst all that confusion, we saw Big Daddy cause a bit of chaos that distracted Cowboy Bob Orton. And ladies and gentlemen, how's this for a debut in SICW? Vic the Bruiser, just a few moments into his SICW career, picking up a pinfall over the legendary Bob Orton, of course, with a bit of an assist for Big Daddy. Of course, this is a 2 out of 3 falls matchup. The Monsters now taking the lead, 1-0. Putting the team of legends behind the proverbial eight ball. And here's Cahagas trying to capitalize on this momentum, not giving Cowboy Bob one moment's rest. And you see the frustration on Ron Powers and Gary Jackson trying to get inside the ring to help their teammate. Referee Jay King got a rough task here. You have six men inside the ring, and of course, Big Daddy on the outside. I think Jay King's gonna have to clone himself once or twice if he's gonna expect to contain the animosity, the chaos in this contest. And here you see Cahagas and Bob Orton were just squaring off there in the corner. That'd be a tremendous one-on-one matchup. It was Jay King giving Cahagas the count of five. Of course, these monsters, although often out of control, have enough wherewithal most of the time to break these illegal holds at the four count before they are disqualified. So a little bit of method to the madness of the monsters. Here you see once again, Cahagas just throttling the neck of the Cowboy. And these three monsters, rather similar in their offensive maneuvers. Maybe Attila Khan and Vic the Bruiser more similar than Cahagas. Cahagas, of course, with those punches, those kicks, those chops, the martial arts background. There's Cowboy Bob, makes the tag to Ron Powers. Ron Powers getting inside the ring for the first time here today. And there you see him. Although the Gary Jackson is the night train, Ron Powers certainly resembling a runaway train right now. Oh, and there's Cahagas crawling through the legs to make the tag to Attila Khan. And here you see these two bulls locking horns. These two have been unable in the past few months to resolve their differences. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got to take a quick break. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Farm Music and Fun, the place to party, is Pop's nightclub and concert venue in Sojay. From Bruno Mars or the first U.S. tour of Nickelback to Flogging Molly or the Insane Clown Posse, 30 years of memories pack Pop's concert venue with more made at every new show. And there's a party at Pop's nightclub every night, a melting pot of friends enjoy the best in dance, rock, pop, and top 40 music until 5:30 a.m. Plus, add a full game room. Check out all the action at PopsRocks.com. Then and now, the place to party is Pop's in Sojay.
Of course, before this matchup started, Ron Powers, I believe his goal is to just be sort of a wrecking ball. He made the comment a few weeks ago, Gary, Jackson, Cowboy Bob, you guys worry about the technical aspects. I'm just gonna come in and destroy. He was doing a pretty successful job at that destruction, but here, Vic the Bruiser in the ring with Ron Powers, I believe this is the first one-on-one meeting between these two men, or any meeting for that matter, and there was Ron Powers getting the best of that exchange with the clothesline, bringing Gary Jackson back inside the ring, who capitalizes with one. There's two elbow drops in the cover. Vic out at one. Gary Jackson, very nice European style uppercuts here. But there's Vic taking the punishment and more than happy to dish it out in return, flooring Gary Jackson with that clothesline, only for a two count. Gary Jackson getting out of there. That's not too shabby teamwork there. We saw Vic the Bruiser just make that pretty clean tag to Attila Khan. Honestly, I'm surprised that these three monsters have been able to coexist as harmoniously as they have. So far, this team of legends has been mostly unable to get any sort of meaningful momentum going in their favor for any sustained stretch of time. And there you saw Jay King with his back turned, Tokyo Monster using that opportunity to dig that boot right into Gary Jackson's throat. Oh, Gary Jackson was making the comeback. Attila Khan cutting him off before Gary Jackson is able to get back to his corner, planted in the center of the ring with that body slam. See what Attila has in mind here. Oh yeah, that falling elbow drop. Gary Jackson getting out of the way, the speed advantage of the Night Train. And now Ron Powers getting another chance to dish out a little punishment on his recent foe, bringing Attila Khan crashing to the mat. Oh, and there's Ron giving Vic a little bit of a how you doing on the outside of the ring there. Oh, it looked like Attila Khan went down into his trunks for that fork of his. You can see it in Ron Powers. He had it. He took Attila's fork and he got him with it and got the three count. Ladies and gentlemen, Ron Powers turning the tables on Attila Khan's plans to bring that fork into play. Tying up this 2 out of 3 falls contest at one fall apiece. So we're all evened up now, folks. Here's Ron Powers bringing Cowboy Bob back into the ring, and this is a rested Cowboy Bob. This is a Cowboy Bob who's had a few moments rest. And here he gets to unleash a little bit of revenge on the man who picked up the three count just a few moments ago. Although, oh, Vic the Bruiser. Tell you what, the fists of Cowboy Bob Orton are legendary. Vic the Bruiser, of course, having the antidote for those blows, sticking the thumb right into the eye of Cowboy Bob and cutting off that momentum swing. Now it's Vic the Bruiser whipping him into the corner. Oh, Cowboy Bob, look at the momentum, almost taking him up and over. I think he caught his head on the steel post there. I'm not too sure. Vic the Bruiser admiring his handiwork, making the tag into Cahagas. And that's smart tag team action, ladies and gentlemen. In these sorts of contests, maintaining your energy is imperative. And this team of monsters has been utilizing their tags very efficiently. There's Cahagas staying all over Cowboy Bob, but Cowboy Bob kicking out at 2. There again, the quick tag. And ladies and gentlemen, if these monsters are able to get on the same page for any sustained period of time here in SICW, we're going to be in big trouble here. Any one of these men can do an incredible amount of damage. And when you combine all of them moving in the same direction towards the same goal, I'm not sure who can stop them. Especially when these men are led by the brain trust of Big Daddy, who was chased away a few moments ago, and Travis Cook, who is absent from ringside for reasons that you will see in the upcoming weeks here on Wrestling Explosion. Meanwhile, Vic the Bruiser still dishing out punishment on Cowboy Bob Orton. I don't want to say that Vic's got Cowboy's number, but in this matchup, it certainly worked out to his favor. We'll have to see about lining up a singles contest between these two somewhere down the road. And there's Cahagas maintaining his team's advantage. And that's exactly what you have to do. You're sapping the energy from Cowboy Bob. You are damaging his body. And in the meanwhile, the longer Ron Powers and Gary Jackson has to wait, it makes them more frustrated, more angry, so that when they do get tagged into the ring, there you go, here's Ron Powers, just tagged him, got himself tagged in. But you have to worry about letting your emotions get the best of you. There's Ron Powers bringing Attila Khan down to the mat with that big boot. Well, ladies and gentlemen, looks like this thing's turning into a bit of a Donnybrook. Gary Jackson and Cahagas in the ring. Ladies and gentlemen, I mentioned him a moment ago. Here you see Travis Cook stumbling to ringside with his head all bandaged up. Ron Powers getting Cahagas out of the ring as all the other men are battling. Folks, looks like Travis Cook handed Attila Khan something from that bandage. He nailed Ron Powers, ladies and gentlemen. That was enough for Attila Khan to get the three count over Ron Powers and the victory for his team. Let's get the official announcement.
In 12 seconds, Attila Khan secured the pinfall over Ron Powers. Therefore, your winners of this matchup, led by Travis Cook and Big Daddy, are Tokyo Monster Cahagas, Attila Khan, and Vic the Bruiser.
Ladies and gentlemen, a valiant effort by our legends, but the odds were just too much to overcome. Cahagas, Attila Khan, and Vic the Bruiser walking away with the win today. Wrestling fans, join SICW as we return to the East Carondelet Community Center Saturday night, August the 20th. Our co-main event, the lovely ladies return to SICW as Paloma Starr takes on Miss Monica. And in our main event, Ron Powers defends the Classic Wrestling Championship in a no DQ, must be a winner contest against Travis Cook's Attila Khan. Reserve your seats at 618-286-4848.
Let Custom Truck Upholstery give your vehicle a facelift. Visit us on 707 North 20th Street in East St. Louis, Illinois. Custom Truck Upholstery merges old world craftsmanship and attention to detail with the latest in modern technology to make your car, truck, boat, or motorcycle look like new. Call Custom Truck Upholstery at 618-875-9850.
Folks, I'm here with the nefarious Mr. Travis Cook and the one and only Mr. Attila Khan. Fairly successful 2 out of 3 falls match. Indeed. Your team picking up the victory, and Mr. Khan picking up the final 3 count, the final pinfall over Ron Powers to secure the victory for your team. So first of all, congratulations, and here's what's that earned you, because as we've seen, Attila Khan versus Ron Powers, weapons, forks, chairs, can't seem to keep themselves outside of the ring. So forget it, we're throwing the rule book out. August the 20th, right here in the East Carondelet Community Center, it's Ron Powers defending the Classic Wrestling Championship against the one and only Attila Khan, but this time it is no disqualifications. Mr. Cook, no DQ with a chance once again to bring the Classic Wrestling Championship back into your stable.
You know, first of all, Drew, I'm shocked that you learned a word like nefarious. I guess the Hooked on Phonics books are working really well for you, but last month, I proved my point. What was the last thing everybody saw last month? The last thing everybody saw was Attila Khan pinning Ron Powers 1, 2-3 cleanly in the center of the ring. And I should say, Attila Khan, you proved my point for me. I shouldn't say that I proved it. But the bottom line is this. I've told you for about 6 months. Every time that Ron Powers and Attila Khan gets in the ring, Ron Powers is left laying. And when the chips were on the line, when you didn't have a woman to hide behind, when you didn't have every referee in the building protecting you, you got beat. And now we're in another situation where all the chips are on the line, a pressure situation, no disqualification, something that supposedly works in the favor of Ron Powers, they say. But I want you to remember something, Ron Powers. Do you remember the last time that you were in one of these matches where everything was set up your way, where it was all your situation, where it was a money match, where all the chips were on the line? Do you remember that? Do you remember what happened? I remember what happened. I ran you out of town. You see, when all the chips are on the line, Attila Khan is the man who physically has your number. And Travis Cook is the man who mentally and strategically has your number. I came up with a game plan that he didn't see coming. I ran him out of town once. And now we're going to take the title. It's no disqualification. We can do anything you want. And he's standing there in that ring all alone with that belt without a woman to hide behind. He's right where we want him.
I do have to add, in that 2 out of 3 falls six-man tag team match, Ron Powers also scored a pinfall over Mr. Khan. So this
I would tread very lightly if I was you. Yes, Ron Powers used a foreign object, something that he's known for all over this world. Because when it comes to a clean, scientific wrestling match with a Attila Khan or anybody else I manage, he's proven over the years he can't hang. So he's got to bring a fork or a chair. We would never do something like that ordinarily, but this time it's no disqualification. We can do whatever we want. So you're going to put us in that kind of situation. We won't be responsible for what we do. Maybe for the first time in history, we'll bring the fork first. We've never done that before. You people know that. But maybe, just maybe this time, we'll bring the fork first. Or the chair. Or a steel girder. Or a ladder. Or whatever we can find. Because Ron Powers, you know better than anybody on this planet that when it comes to a game plan, you cannot keep up with Travis Cook. And when it comes to the physicality in the ring, you cannot keep up with Attila Khan because you're left laying every single time you see him.
Well, folks, if that happens August 20th, we're going to have a new classic wrestling champion in Attila Khan. And back home in the Travis Cook organization, folks, don't forget, everything they said they can do, so can Ron. The East Carondelet Community Center, I imagine, will be left looking like a crater more than a building when this is over. Attila Khan challenges for the classic title versus Ron Powers, August 20th, East Carondelet Community Center. Don't miss this one.
Polish up my belt.
You heard Travis Cook. The main event is set for August 20th, but fans, don't go away. As soon as we come back from break, we've got a special treat for you as 8-year-old up-and-coming singing sensation Brooklyn Nichols delivers an amazing rendition of the Star-Spangled Banner.
Velva Mechanical Incorporated is the place to go for commercial and industrial heating, ventilation, air conditioning, and refrigerating work. Their Union Sheet Metal Shop is the most modern, well-equipped in southwestern Illinois. Their work on the SIUE Engineering Building won Velva Mechanical the Madigan Special Merit Award for New Construction. Call 233-0081 for information. Belleville Mechanical will fabricate ductwork and custom fittings to your specifications. The highest union quality, superb workmanship, state-of-the-art equipment. Contact Belleville Mechanical.
SICW is pleased to welcome as a new sponsor Warma Witter Chrysler & Associates, Inc., independent insurance agent specializing in public entity insurance. For all your insurance needs, contact Bradley J. Chrysler at 618-632-7555, extension 806. That's 618-632-7555. When it comes to customer service for your insurance coverage, let Warma Witter Chrysler & Associates assist you.
Ladies and gentlemen, SICW is proud to begin all of our events with the Star-Spangled Banner. This past July, we were joined by the 8-year-old sensation Brooklyn Nichols to deliver this beautiful edition of our national anthem. Brooklyn, take it away. Wrestling fans, join SICW as we return to the East Carondelet Community Center Saturday night, August the 20th. Our co-main event, the lovely ladies return to SICW as Paloma Starr takes on Miss Monica. And in our main event, Ron Powers defends the Classic Wrestling Championship in a no DQ, must be a winner contest against Travis Cook's Attila Khan. Reserve your seats at 618-286-4848.
From the World Series champion Tigers in 45 to the Gateway Grizzlies to the 03 State Tournament Belleville East Lancers. A tradition in baseball, and an even longer tradition in fine furniture and service. Miller Furniture, 1004 East Main in Belleville.
Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for joining us for another terrific episode of Wrestling Explosion. And because of the actions in our closing moments, the main event is set for August the 20th as Ron Powers is defending his Classic Wrestling Championship against Attila Khan, but this time it is no disqualification. Ladies and gentlemen, again, that's August the 20th in the East Carondelet Community Center. Folks, thanks for joining us. I'm Drew Abenhouse, and we'll see you right here next week on Charter Cable or the Fight TV app.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, how about an SICW debut for Vic the Bruiser?